outgoing message, and I can push it, and it's louder. So you can, do you want to speak for it?
I don't want to speak for it. Hey, this is John. You should leave a message. Where's the mic at?
Where was right here.
Oh, right there. Hello.
Oh, yes. Say a bunch of words with S's in them.
Sibilance is not the nastiest thing in the world, but it's surely, I don't know any other S words.
Well, your extreme DC bias as a result of this, because this is a very DC bias on the outgoing message with this condenser microphone.
I can't believe you went out to the tennis when I'm trying to get Magnolia pulled together. That's really insulting. Don't you have to work for a living? Bye. This is Terry Holmes. Yeah, I just got in and got your message at 6 o'clock. Give me a call when you do, and I'll be here the rest of the night. My number is 758-2817. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Ford Industries, September 23rd, 1982.
Outgoing message, and I can push it, and it's louder. So you can, do you want to speak for it?
I don't want to speak for it. Hey, this is John. You should leave a message. Where's the mic at?
Where was right here.
Oh, right there. Hello.
Oh, yes. Say a bunch of words with S's in them.
Sibilance is not the nastiest thing in the world, but it's surely, I don't know any other S words.
With your extreme DC bias as a result of this, because this is a very DC bias on the outgoing message with this condenser microphone.
Martha, this is Kay. Your recording machine is so faint I can't really hear it, but I did recognize your voice. I did not have a call from the gas company this afternoon. It's 10 minutes after 6 now, and now I'm answering service over there already. This is Kay. What you just got was an April Fool's or a ho ho ho.
Outgoing message, and I can push it, and it's louder. So you can, do you want to speak for it?
I don't want to speak for it. Hey, this is John. You should leave a message. Where's the mic at?
Where was right here.
Oh, right there. Hello.
Oh, yes. Say a bunch of words with S's in them.
Sibilance is not the nastiest thing in the world, but it's surely, I don't know any other S words.
With your extreme DC bias as a result of this, because this is a very DC bias on the outgoing message with this condenser microphone.
Music recorded at the high sensitivity setting. Now I record it at the low setting.
A million miles away, they want to take our hearts and they want to take our souls. Now they're coming for us, better make an escape. Gotta take some action before it gets too late.
Now you will be hearing how a recording sounds when there is no bias at all. I played the line level output from this cassette recorder into the record head of the message tape. And now I have the recording with no bias at all. Here we go. Oops, wrong tape. I played the outgoing. It's the now it's wait, I'm confused. Here we go. This is it. If you got any recorders that sound like that, possibility is that the bias oscillator is not working at all. Or if it's DC bias, that there's no DC bias coming into it at all. Prepare to be amazed. I have successfully, in an experiment, accomplished a successful AC bias for the first time. This analog exerciser that I have has a built-in signal generator. I made a high-frequency sine wave signal, put it through this little transformer, the primary only going to the generator. The secondary went to the head, this tape head here, and also to the line out. So the signal's coming in here, going to the head directly. At the same time, the 6 volts of AC bias was being put to the head. I took this wire off so I wouldn't have a 60 hertz hum during playback. But listen to the result. Okay, right there is when I turned the oscillator off. And it went to no bias. I am amazed by this. This is a very big accomplishment in my tape recorder whereabouts. For the first time I have successfully recorded coming from no bias to with the line output from another recorder. Coming into my own AC bias, except this is using this signal generator. Now I know. I need to build a generator that will make a high frequency like that. Drive a transformer. The other side go with the tape head and the audio, and boom, I'll have bias. Okay. It says sine wave, triangle, and square wave. Okay, in this recording you will the first part will be heard from the what's recorded with the sine wave being used as the bias oscillator. Now this is going through a transformer, so it might not come out just right when having the sawtooth and square waves, but each time you hear a sound, you know, a little popping like staticky sound, that's whenever I turn the knob to the next wave in this playback of this. And I want you to take notice, the last one is the square wave, the first is the sine wave, then it's the triangle, then it's the square. I think that the square wave has better quality. Now you be the judge. When this the square wave came in, the audio quality was considerably better. It's like, whoa, this is the different waveforms and its effect on the sound quality when using the bias oscillator.